Hey, you guys, Coach Hannah here. Today we are talking all about expectations and how you're kind of being lied to a lot here on social media without actually being lied to. So what kind of prompted this is the post I made yesterday. The very first picture on that post is a before and after of me with the title, it was a 4-month transformation. So I decided over quarantine, I decided to do a cut. So I took a picture at the start of the cut, and it's good to take those so then you have progress throughout. And at the very end of the cut, I knew I had a photo shoot coming up with a local fitness photographer. So technically I didn't lie to you. Those pictures were taken exactly 4 months apart. The issue is without context, if someone's just scrolling on social media, maybe you've never worked out a day in your life and you're like, I kind of look like her before shot in 4 months, I can look like that, done. So all of a sudden, the expectation is that in 4 months, you get to look like the person you saw on Instagram. With context, if you keep scrolling, you'll see my very first progress picture photo. One, I was too embarrassed to even show my face because I held the phone right there because I was not going to be associating this face with that body. No. It was over eight years ago, somewhere around there, 8-ish years ago. So maybe more realistic picture is the second picture you scrolled to in the post yesterday, where it was 2013 and then 2020. No, it does not take 8 years to completely transform your body or transform your life, but the end photo, that after shot, what went into that was consistent training and nutrition and water and all the things consistently for more than 4 months. You can't go from not exercising to all of a sudden expecting to look like a fitness model overnight because you saw someone else's before and after on Instagram and they gave you zero context. So then if you scroll to the third photo that I put on yesterday, it is the least popular one, of course. It was my very first progress photo to what I looked like at the start of this cut. There's still a 40-pound difference, but it's not as flashy, it's not as fancy, it's not as exciting. So when you're scrolling, this is just such an issue of mine with social media, is the expectation when you see these before and afters is if you don't get that, if you don't look like someone else's after in the time frame underneath their photo, you clearly failed. You did something wrong. When in reality, you may be right on the right track. You could be well on your way to that after photo of you that you're seeking, but because you didn't look like someone else, you stop before you give yourself a shot because maybe that someone else didn't give you the entire picture of information. So I get it. It's fun, and that's why we post these things on social media. You know, you highlight, you know, your weight loss clients that do the best, have the most shocking things, because on social media you're doing this. So if it doesn't look like damn, you're actually probably not going to stop. So people are trying to get your attention. There's nothing wrong with that. No one's lying, but it's leading you to believe that things happen quickly, or if they don't happen as quickly as someone else, you're doing something wrong. So it's one of those where a lot of times it's why you just keep saying nothing ever works for me. Nothing ever works for me. I did this weight loss program for 2 weeks and I didn't lose a single pound. Okay. Maybe you weren't supposed to lose weight those first 2 weeks. Maybe you were assessing your metabolism. Maybe your body was just trying to figure out what the hell you were doing. We are so tuned into I want results and I want results right now that if you don't get the results right now, you stop doing the things that eventually lead to that result just because you didn't get there fast enough. So yesterday in my stories, I actually post a video of a client. We have been together for a full year. So if I opened with like 20 pounds down in 1 year, everyone's thinking, hell no, that's way too long. I want 20 pounds down in like 3-4 months tops. Of course you're thinking that. Of course, I would think the same thing. I want that too. That's great. But for her, we lost 15 pounds in just over 20 weeks. Then life was getting a little bit busy. She was kind of losing that like vigor, getting a little bit more munchy, a little bit more lackadaisical, which isn't wrong. That's super normal. So then we took a formal, intentional 3-month break at maintenance calories, ended up being a little bit longer than that. Now we're back into a fat loss phase. Now we're losing weight again. So now she is 20 pounds down. She's lost 7 inches off of her waist. And so it took her a year. Who cares how long it takes you to get there if you get there and you can stay there? I had a conversation recently with someone that wanted to become a client, and she was so laser focused on losing this X number of pounds before Christmas, no matter the cost. I'm like, right there, I know we're just not a good fit. I get it. Trust me, early on, if someone told me to drink rat poison to lose weight, I would have done it. I'm not kidding. I get that charged. I need this to happen right now. But if you keep losing and gaining the same 10 to 20 pounds over and over again, something isn't working. You have no problem losing weight. Your problem is keeping the weight off. So what if it took you a little bit longer to lose those 10 to 20 pounds, you developed habits, and you had an exit strategy to get out of diet mode to make sure you keep the weight loss so you don't have to keep buying the cheap detox shred 30-day booty buster whatever year after year after year, and you make one investment in yourself and you fucking commit. That's what's missing on social media, is the expectation that you have to commit to something and then you have to do it and you have to keep doing it to get the end result. It's not a quick, you get to get a tan, wear a sparkly bikini and eat huge desserts every single night and do like no cardio ever because I just don't put me down for cardio. That's not real life. Some people are like that. That's so great. There are genetic anomalies and I could just punch them in the face. I am not one of those people. I'm not a naturally skinny girl by social media standard of the definition. I have to work for it. So when I post client transformations of before and after, I try and always bring in how it happened, context for everything. Because, all right, let's go back to my post yesterday. Let's say you saw my post, 4-month transformation. You're thinking, I'm going to look like that in 4 months. So if in 2 months you don't feel like you're halfway there, you instantly think you're doing something wrong. There is something wrong with your approach. So then you start having less motivation or confidence in what you're doing. So then you're more likely to stop doing it or cheat on your diet. And then you never actually see what you're capable of if you just kept going, because the expectation is you would be at point X by set point of time. Those are great things to strive for and find motivation in, but you gotta be realistic about the expectation and how you're going to get there. That is something I really lay down thick with my clients, is this is what we are looking for, but as long as we are moving the needle forward the right direction toward your optimal goal, that is the biggest picture. So it takes us 3 more weeks to lose that extra pound. Who gives a shit? Because you didn't stop. It's those that, if you don't get that instant gratification and then you stop, you get to say, oh, I hired that coach. She didn't do anything for me. Or, yeah, I tried macro counting. It doesn't work for me. Oh, yeah. I always do better on low carb, but I can't stick with that for like long term. It's, you're putting up these reasons why nothing's ever worked for you. And you're right. Nothing has worked up to this point because you haven't put in the work up to this point. So yesterday, that post, that second one is the most realistic. That was an 8-year transformation to get there. That's not flashy. That's not fancy. There are people on here promising extraordinary results for faster and cheaper, and that's completely fine as long as you actually can deliver. I remember I got a message on Instagram. One girl wanted to ask about my coaching services, and we just started talking, and I was like, you know, just tell me a little bit about yourself, you know, what you're looking for and what you've tried in the past that hasn't worked and things like that. And it was followed with, I've never worked out before. I'm a little uncomfortable in the gym and I want to look like this in 3 months. And it was a picture of this like shredded fitness model and this like ridiculous pose. And I was like, girl, I couldn't look like that in 3 months if I tried. And I've been lifting for a decade. Like, it's, we lose context. If we can't have it now, we don't want it. And then we spend the next X number of years of our life complaining that it never really worked for us. We're just not built like that. We just don't have the capacity to achieve it. When in reality, you got to step the hell up. So social media is such a fun place to be inspired and see what is capable, what the body can do. It's awesome. But don't let an unrealistic expectation stop you from moving the right direction. What if you're losing inches off your waist and you're not seeing it on the scale? What if a pair of jeans fits, zips, comfortably and make your ass look fantastic, but you didn't reach that certain number on the scale in a certain number of weeks. Are you still failing? No. The expectation that things happen an X number of time for everyone is the issue of social media, and I have a full breakdown of this and a little bit more of a realistic expectation going out to email subscribers only tonight. So you have until 3, that's when it's gonna go, 3 p.m. Central Time to click that link in my bio if you're not a subscriber, or else you are going to miss it. It is not going to be sent again. So basically, all I wanna talk about was setting out a realistic expectation. If your expectation is that you're going to lose 10 pounds in 2 weeks, then all of a sudden it doesn't happen, and you all of a sudden think you're doing the wrong thing or you failed, then you're not gonna stick with anything long enough to ever actually get that aftershot that you want. If you want the aftershot, you have to put in the work. You can't only look at the scale, and you can't be looking at what everyone else is doing if you are making unique progress toward you. So it's all about realistic expectations for what you're trying to accomplish. Don't let any post I've ever made, don't let any post you see on social media make you think things are possible without context. If something really doesn't make sense, if someone's like, I haven't been on a diet in 20 years and I look like a fitness model and I don't even lift weights. If you're thinking, how the hell did she do that? Ask for context before you hold yourself to that standard. Because what you don't see are the consistent workouts, 4 or 5, sometimes 6 days a week for me. What you don't see are the times that I said, no thanks, I'm not gonna drink tonight, even though I'm going out with my friends, I'll be the driver, no problem. What you didn't see is sometimes going to the Mexican restaurant and not mowing down the bowl of tortilla chips. What you didn't see is sometimes drinking pounding those extra 2 glasses of water because I was too far behind on my water that day and I just needed to slam it. You don't see the things that really happen behind the scenes when all you see is a before and after. In X number of months, I get to look like this, when really years go into the making of those end shots that people really wanna see. And if you put in the work, girl, you can get there. You can accomplish it. Trust me, if I can do this, anybody can totally do this. But you have to do this. You can't expect it to happen overnight. You can't expect it to be easy. And you can't expect it to be without frustrations, difficulties, or sacrifices. But you also can expect it to be sustainable and it not suck near as bad as you probably think.